So let's start. Here, I'll move this down. Stickers I got on here. That one got in Vancouver. This is a print that I made for my art class, experimenting with like, it's not lino, but it's rubber block prints. And then this is me writing about a dream I had that is really, really embarrassing that no one should read. And I like to fill up every single space I can with my sketchbook, like as much as possible, as you can see. So, stupid, embarrassing dream. This is just pencil work because I hadn't done pencil work in a while. FKA Twigs, she's great, love her. These are some outfits that I was frequently wearing, and so I kind of wanted to draw them and document them, and this is a little actual lizard wizard. Again, in philosophy class, drew this inspired by The Matrix. I have a lot of flippy up things of, I hate what's under here, so I'll cover it up. This is the microtonal guitar. These are some bust portraits. There's a lot of them. And I have a lot of like different motifs that I use to fill the space. From like telling right now, it's been butterflies and eyeballs and stars. Just shapes and stuff that I like. These are, again, more cutouts. I draw a lot on like scrap pieces of paper. Like I remember this was on a math test and I was like, I'm gonna keep it and cut it out. It's a cool little, cool sci-fi lady. A lot of the cutouts I do, I'll try and have a colored background. What I use for these colored backgrounds is highlighters and Posca pens, but like almost dead Posca pens, like paint pens. This, I use some watercolor on this, and then a Sharpie. This is, again, a different page from a different book. Just some ink stuff, some band stuff, guitar practice. This is another print I made in art class. Just still life. This is a cutout of Tupac that my friend gave me, and I found that he needed a place in here because he's a legend. That's inappropriate. Don't look at that. This is a drawing of the storage room in my, or like the storage shelf in my art room, because it was for a art room, like, or art class assignment of like, you know, observational drawing. It's pretty cool. Paints and like a bunch of pastel cartons and shit. Oh, great, violin. This is a drawing my friend did. Love you, Jasper. She's awesome. You know, maybe some shirt designs. This was supposed to be a block print design inspired by The Garden. They're a great band. This is a little Posca pen self-portrait moment. There's a lot of different inspirations behind like stuff like this. This vibrant ass like art stuff. This is a little Basquiat inspired moment. I fucking love him. He's so inspiring. This was another cutout from that last day of art class. Just a little scrap. These three sketches were actually for a philosophy project where we had to take an idea, like a philosophical practice, and present it in a visual way or in a way that wasn't an essay, because essays are boring. I ended up going with this one. I'm gonna throw up the final product on screen here. But I believe the philosophy that I took was existentialism. And so it's really interesting. And I did want to make it like a full painted piece. I also did want to make these painted pieces. I really like these. These are just some kind of observational sketches of my environment. So this was, we were at the beach and I drew our boat, and you know, kid that was at the beach, this is a little log in the park. This is a door on a ferry, but as you can see, it's a fold out here. And this was a kind of original concept sketch for a painting I ended up doing. I'll put it on screen here. But it was pretty rad. Again, more prints. You know, just graphite studies to show that I can actually do traditional artwork. This was a study of a mountain on the train. More prints. My friend again drew her in class. This was at the river. Again, my friend. God, I must like her or something. Okay. These, were album cover concepts for my friend's band that I am now in. I helped record their album because I have a home stew. This was just, I like visualizing lists I need, and then this is my block rotations for like my classes. Again, these were just pages done outside of the sketchbook, so I glued them in. Okay, this page is interesting because this is a background that ended up becoming a painting of mine through lots of process. I've actually got it right beside me here. This painting, or this sketch, ended up becoming this painting. I can't have them side by side, but, you know, I really liked, you know, the contrast of the dark blue and red. This was very, I think, I was looking at some Matisse paintings, and I really liked the shape in them, but then I felt that this, like, I really want to do abstract kind of shape work like this, but I felt that it needed something on the side just as a balance or as a contrast. Because, like, it's pretty, it's balanced, but it was too boring. And this is oil pastel. I do a lot of high, like, saturated color work in pastel, at least when I'm, like, getting out concepts. This is a cool bouzouki. It's an instrument that I really want to get. And then some more just ballpoint pen sketches. Okay, again, I forgot that this was there, but yeah. I was like, something needs to be protruding from the side here. I just felt it needed that. These are anatomy. This is, or this, I guess, specifically is an anatomy sketch. Studied from a book. Took my time on it. More anatomy sketches. Show off those classical, you know, technical skills. I really need to get better at, like, line of action and, like, figure drawings. Being more relaxed rather than trying to get details. Trying to just capture the shape and the movement. More film concepts. Just in a storyboard. More textural or pattern work, line work. And then this was, again, this was inspired by Fiona Apple. I was listening to her album before school one day, and I just really, really wanted to draw stuff with lyrics. I love putting lyrics in with my art, because my music and art is so interconnected. candle study, I have a little candle in my room. These are my Monstera leaves. This was inspired by the Smashing Pumpkins, Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness cover. Film class ideas and inspiration. That's a great croc drawing. No, don't let me see you crying. This is just a awesome mushroom man doodle, which I really, really like. It's kind of gross. Very gross, actually. But I love doing detailed ink work with textures and stuff, especially if it's disgusting. And none of these hands were drawn with a reference, clearly, because they're bad. These are some intentional, building drawings, like architecture studies, because I realized I did not have enough of them. This was a study of one of my highlighters. I don't really like them. I like this one. My cross-hatching needs work. And that's it. This is more brightly saturated color stuff I just love. And then done November 6th, 2022. Alright. Thanks for watching.